Throughout history, the person that people fear, the group of people that people fear, they become caricatures and they become less human, and then it's okay to fear them. The people who are the quote-unquote black sheep of the family, they still want to be part of the family.
Yeah.
The family decides, even if it's subconsciously, this person is the problem. Every gift helps your family, but if your family doesn't value it and doesn't understand it, that's on them, that's not on you.
Bruno left our family because you only saw the worst in
him. Bruno didn't care about this family.
He loves this family.
But I love my family, you know?
Welcome to Cinema Therapy. I am Alan Seawright. I'm a professional filmmaker who needs therapy.
And I'm Jonathan Decker, licensed therapist who loves movies.
Oh, we need to introduce our guest.
And this is Gandalf.
This is Gandalf the White. He's been my friend through many travels.
What are we doing today?
We didn't talk enough about Bruno.
We barely talked about Bruno. And by popular demand, I'm taking it because people are asking.
People have been asking us to talk about Bruno.
We don't talk about Bruno.
I know.
So, we're going to talk about Bruno.
All right, bring it on.
Such a perfect match.
So perfect.
So good for the Encanto.
So this, like, one of the things I wanted to talk to you about is, even before he had sort of separated himself from the family, he was really cut off from the family by...
where he lived.
His tower.
Yeah.
Casita, can you turn off the sand? You can't help in here? I'll be fine.
Not in a magic room, apparently.
For you?
For abuela?
Maybe a little for me.
This is one of the all-time great jokes.
Find the vision. Save the mirror.
And they didn't have to go so hard, and they did it for us.
Oh, gosh.
Look at this. She pulls sand out of her eyelids. Just makes me itchy. Oh, so good.
As she's approaching the door to his bedroom, I'm just thinking of the whole phrase black sheep. Like, there's someone in every family that doesn't...
Pause you for 1 second.
But at least I'll have a friend. Nope, he flew away immediately.
Sorry, just another great line. You were saying, approaches the door to the bedroom.
Oh, just... hang on, this is... I relate to this.
Way to get so high because we're magic, but no!
Magical maesters fit in here! Bruno, the room is the worst!
A lot of families have someone that they like kind of keep out of the way, that they're not...
The black sheep.
Yeah, the black sheep. We talked about this in our last Encanto episode, but at least Mirabel is welcome.
Oh, yeah.
At least Mirabel is part of the family.
Yeah.
Bruno is completely on the outside, and you see this a lot where someone has... a lifestyle, or they have a belief system, or they have a worldview that doesn't fit in at all with the rest of the family, and it's like, well,
you're not welcome here anymore.
Yeah,
yeah.
That whatever it is, like they say, nothing trumps family, but far too often there's
an ideology or there's a something that trumps family.
Yeah.
If he had a vision about someone. What would it mean?
We don't talk about Bruno.
I know. It's just hypothetically, if he saw you.
Mirabel, please. We need to get ready for the Guzmans.
I just want to know if it was generally positive or like less positive.
It was a nightmare.
Feliz.
She needs to know, baby. She needs to know.
We don't talk about Bruno.
He would see something terrible and then crack. Ba-da, boom. It would happen.
We don't talk about Bruno.
What if you didn't understand what he saw?
Then you better figure it out because it was coming for you.
We don't talk about Bruno.
So the idea is that he says something that comes true, like he creates it instead of it's going to happen anyway.
It's going to happen anyway. It was a waiting day. Yeah, you could just as easily perceive this as like, oh, he's giving helpful warnings beforehand.
Yeah.
To prepare for a thing that's going to come. But, you know, human nature is not that.
I'm sorry, me be that go. That's my favorite
line
in the
whole song. I'm going to just break into song this whole time. Such a catchy tune.
But you see this also in families like this family that are accustomed to not talking about the hard things. They're conflict avoidant. They like to hide behind this veneer of perfection. and everything comes out passive aggressively, and then you have someone who speaks the truth, and people see them as a jerk or as a problem. Instead of it, they're trying to help. Well, and how scary Bruno looks in these, in this projection.
Yeah.
And throughout history, the person that people fear, or the group of people that people fear, their character, they become caricatures. Yeah. And they become less human, and then it's okay to fear them.
Right. Just like he said, he said that all my hair would disappear. Now look at my hair. I never noticed the glint on his head before. Right? That's hilarious.
Some of this isn't gift of prophecy. It's, dude, you were getting middle-aged. You were going to get a gut.
Yeah. Would be promised
and
someday be mine. And again, you didn't do anything about it. He told you, and you're just like, okay. My power would grow like the grapes
that thrive on the vine. Well, in various cultures and various traditions and various work, you know, sacred books of different world faiths, the people who foresee the future are stoned or crucified or killed or persecuted. Yeah. And then we have this, prophets of doom is what they're called, right?
Right.
But we have a similar thing. We treat scientists like this today. Like,
sure, yeah.
Oh, you're telling me something I don't want to hear.
Climate change sounds gross. Let's not talk about that.
And so then we attack the people instead of the message as a warning. Right. Yeah. And so, and we do this in our families. As I was saying, some people try and be a voice of reason and say what they see is happening, and we would rather stay in our shells. And then things escalate and get worse until we can't run from them anymore. And that doesn't mean someone who speaks their mind is always right. But it does mean that it's a healthy thing to say what's going on and what you're observing. See, now she sees it as I talked about Bruno and brought the curse on myself.
Got your party pants on? Cause I...
I broke into Bruno's tower. I found his last vision. The family's in trouble. The magic is dying. The house is breaking. Luisa's gift is fading. And I think it's all because of me. Bah.
Her dad, voiced by Wilder Villarama, who played Fez on that 70s show.
I know, he's so great.
Wants tonight to be perfect. Till the Guzmans leave, you did not break into Bruno's tower. The magic is not dying. The house is not breaking. Luisa's gift is not fading. No one will know. Just act normal. No one has to know.
I know. She's gonna tell everyone.
She's going to tell everyone.
But that's the thing about conflict avoidance is it buys you time, but what it's buying you is when this all comes to a head later on, and I know because I have this problem.
It's going to be worse.
It's going to be so much worse later on, and that's what her dad's doing. He's packing it all up, and he's like, let's just not deal with this right now. And we hope it'll just go away, and it never goes away. And so it's important to learn how to navigate conflict, which is why we have a course on our membership site right here. Fight, Let's Connect More. Check it out.
One of the things I loved about this scene, and it's something that Lin-Manuel Miranda does really, really well, and of course, he didn't do all the choreography and everything. There were other choreographers, and there's animators and people doing stuff, but he wrote a song that is a very musical theater, you know, building up to a crescendo song where people are singing over the top of each other. The directors, animators, and choreographers for Encanto just leaned right the hell in, and they were like, okay, so we're gonna have everyone dancing around this table that's in a blacked out room. It feels like it's on a stage.
Yeah.
You know, you could easily see this in the middle of Hamilton or whatever stage production. The dresser is plunked down and she's arranging the things and it's on the little turntable and it's spinning around and everyone's dancing around her. It just feels,
yeah,
in the best possible way, like musical theater, but it does it in an animated cinematic way, which is super fun. And that's one of the things I love about all the musical numbers in Encanto. All of them have those very stagey moments. A lot of them are also very, very cinematic and big, but they also, you know, obviously all of these people really love musical theater, which is super fun.
It's like Les Miserables One Day More, where they all have their different parts, and at the end it all just kind of converges.
It's
just like,
and it's all tumbling over itself. And
yeah, super cool.
That also fits with the family dynamic, so it's doing multiple storytelling tasks. It's like these people know what they're doing. Good job, Disney. We don't talk about Bruno, and a lot of people don't talk about mental health, but what we should be talking about is both of those things.
Absolutely. Today's video is sponsored by BetterHelp in honor of Mental Health Awareness Month, which helps raise awareness to fight stigma and provide support for anyone struggling with their mental health.
This year's theme is Together for Mental Health, which is something we are all about here at Cinema Therapy, obviously.
Mental Health Awareness Month and BetterHelp are all about advocating easier and better access to mental health care.
That is correct. That's why BetterHelp has a network of over 20,000 therapists to give you access to a broad range of expertise that may not be available to you in your area where you live.
You just fill out a questionnaire to assess your needs, and BetterHelp will match you with a therapist within 48 hours. They offer customized online therapy that includes video, phone, and live chat sessions with your therapist.
So you don't even have to see anyone on camera if you don't want to.
Don't look at me. Don't look.
And you can request a new therapist at any time, free of charge, in case that turned you off.
It's more affordable than traditional offline therapy.
True.
They accept HSA benefits.
Bonus.
And financial aid is available.
Super great. This Mental Health Awareness Month, if you or someone you know is struggling with their mental health, please share BetterHelp with them. Visit betterhelp.com/cinematherapy. That's better H-E-L-P.
Click the link below and get 10% off your first month at betterhelp.com/cinematherapy.
BetterHelp. It's like good help, but better.
Masita! Masita! Help me! Help me!
You're very sweaty. Bye.
Hold on. Wait. Ow. Why did you take the vision? What does it mean? Is it why you came back?
So I really want to talk to you, like...
Knock on wood. You would never...
Can you diagnose this man? Is this OCD? Is this... I mean, there's potential, like, dissociative identity disorder here in a second.
Yeah.
Is there a lot of things? Is there one thing?
Wait. Have you been in here patching the cracks?
There's definitely
that? No.
OCD tendencies there.
All the patching's done by Hernando.
Who is Hernando?
I'm Hernando and I'm scared of nothing.
It's actually me. I say my real gift was acting.
Yeah, so not the ID, because
it's not the ID because he's acting.
Because he knows he's acting.
That's
so awkward.
Back here.
How long have you been back here?
But there's definitely compulsions there. Like, if I don't do this, then something bad could happen, and I have to do it over and over and over. Knock, 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 knock. He's got his whole sequence there.
I left my tower, which was, you know, a lot of stairs, and in here, eh? Kitchen adjacent. Ooh. Plus, free entertainment. So what do you like? What do you like? You like sports?
Game shows.
Telenovelas.
Telenovelas.
Love could never be.
I don't understand.
Well, because she's his aunt and she has amnesia, so she can't remember that she's his aunt. I say it's like a very forbidden kind
of... I don't understand why you left but didn't leave.
But he's into all this entertainment, the acting for himself, all these habits, because he's so alone.
Yeah.
And when we don't have real connection, we sacrifice, you know, we get really into TV shows, we get really into movies, I mean, even more so than normal, to a point where we're out of balance because we don't want to have actual relationships.
Right.
Or we want to, but we're not. And we touched on this in our last Encanto episode, how heartbreaking this is. I mean, he's there where he can see, and he's got his own little table in there, his own little place at the table, that the people who are the quote-unquote black sheep of the family, they still want to be part of the family.
Yeah.
Yeah, my gift wasn't helping the family, but I love my family. You know, I just don't know how to. Well, anyway, I think you should go because,
I'm going to talk about this line because we already had this joke in the last one, but every gift helps your family and helps or can. But if your family doesn't value it and doesn't understand it, that's on them. That's not on you.
I just wanted to make the family proud of me. Just once.
And they're bonding here because now they're both black sheep.
But if I should stop, if I'm hurting my family, just tell me.
This reminds me of something in my field known as the identified patient.
Oh, okay, yeah.
The identified patient is that in many families, there is someone who the family decides, even if it's subconsciously, this person is the problem.
Right, and so this is the person that we've got to fix and cure, and then everything will be okay.
And then everything will be okay. Yeah. We don't talk about Bruno. Very often, these people, these family members, these black sheep, they're the identified patient. Let me tell you what this looks like. Maybe a couple are fighting all the time, and they're on the verge of getting a divorce, and then their teenager starts acting out, right? Starts sleeping, having a lot of sexual partners. Starts using drugs, starts doing graffiti, like all sorts of stuff.
Sure.
And the parents are really worried, and now the parents are unified, and they're worried for the kid. And they start to say, we would get along great if we weren't so stressed about this person.
Right.
Right? And this happens in offices, this happens in teams, this happens in sports teams, this happens everywhere. Like, everything kind of hones in on this one person. And sometimes, yeah, there are problem behaviors there. Other times, it's really just, we're going to let this person hold all of it so that we can believe in our own goodness and our own perfection. And these people come to family therapy and they always say the same thing to the therapist. Instead of, we don't talk about Bruno, they say, can you fix Bruno?
Can we fix six Bob the Builder?
No, I'm afraid I can't.
Right.
Bruno's the problem. In family systems theory, you look at the interplay between all of the members of the family and how one affects the other and vice versa, and it can get very layered and very complex.
I'm sure it's super convoluted.
It's so much easier to just label one person the problem.
Right.
But what ends up happening is, if I just worked with the teen, if I quote-unquote fix the teen, then the couple would have
They're
to see...
They're still fighting.
Yeah, we've still got problems, right? And so this family right now has put Bruno in the identified patient role. His visions have caused all of the bad things that have happened to us. If it wasn't for Bruno, then we wouldn't have any problems. And then he leaves to protect her, and they say Bruno doesn't care about his family.
Right.
And Bruno is this, he's got this evil gift, and he's just a bad seed and a bad apple. And maybe some of you who are watching are the identified patient in your family. You're the person that holds all of the problems. You're the person who takes most of the blame. And you hear it from enough people, and you start to think maybe it's true.
Yeah.
I can tell you categorically, it is not true.
Not true.
It's not true. That's impossible.
The reason I became a relationship therapist, a marriage and family therapist, is because no person exists in a vacuum. And that if you help one person, that doesn't necessarily translate into changing the system.
Right.
But the system, if the system doesn't change, like all the dynamics between the people don't change, then this person's progress can slide back.
Okay.
And so you have to work with the family in tandem, in unison, which is exactly what ends up happening here to heal the family. It's not just one person.
Why would embracing Isabella do anything?
I don't know.
So he's seen a vision that she has to embrace Isabella, and that's going to fix the family.
Oh, I think we're running out of time here.
It's not gonna work. She won't hug me, ever, okay? She hates me.
Also, I don't know if you heard, I ruined her proposal.
Plus, P.S. It is just annoying. Oh, of course it's Isabel.
And what's her problem with me anyway? She's the one with roses coming out of her-
Isabel! Oh, sorry. You see, you're missing the point. The fate of the family, it's not up to her. It's up to you. You're exactly what this family needs. You just have to see it. By yourself, after I leave.
You're not coming?
It was your vision, Mirabel, not mine.
You're afraid of Willa will see you.
Yep, I mean, yes, that too. Hey, after you save the miracle, come visit.
After I save the miracle, I'm bringing you home.
Knock, 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 knock on wood.
So I love that he has this vision, and in the vision, it's kind of, you know, like one of those images you can go back and forth and it can be two different things.
Yeah.
I think when we're dealing with other people, we're much more optimistic, you know? We're trying to encourage them, inspire them, it's going to be okay, things like, when it's our own life, we're like, everything's lost, everything's ruined, and we're never going to get it back.
Oh, I'm a loser!
And there is something, speaking of, you know, prophets and prophecies and prophets of doom, the idea of a self-fulfilling prophecy, what you manifest, what you set out to do. We don't have full creative control over our lives. There are other factors at play, other people's free will, circumstances, what have you. But we increase our chances of success simply by believing that we can.
That's, yeah, that is 100% true.
Which is why whenever you say, stuff like, I'm such a failure, or this is gonna be terrible. Have you seen my tail?
What's the point?
I'm like, Alan, just come on, believe in yourself.
I love
it. It's all cover. I believe in myself so strongly, it's really upsetting.
But Bruno is definitely like this, where he has a hard time believing in himself, but he's so encouraging and loving towards her.
Yeah.
Which is why he's like, you got this, I believe in you.
Bye.
Farewell. Yeah, and he rolls backwards.
It's such a great exit from a scene. I wish I could do that out of every room.
Right, but what does he do? Does he land on his back on the wood? Does he backflip and land on his feet?
Sadly, this is where my headspace is at. I'm so tired. I was like, oh, they put a crash pad down. It's an animated film. He's not real. He didn't need to land on a crash pad.
It's been a long shoot day, folks.
Oh, boy. Guys, this is our fifth episode of the day.
Bueller. Bueller.
Let's watch the next one.
Some magic that you've got. The miracle is you, not some gift, just you. The miracle is you.
All of you, all of you.
Okay, so we're gonna talk about Bruno.
It's Bruno.
Yeah, there's a lot to say about Bruno. I'll start, okay. Pep, I'm sorry about your waiting. Didn't mean to be upsetting. That wasn't a prophecy. I could just see you were sweating. And I wanted you to know that your bro loves you so. Let it in, let it out, let it rain, let it snow, let it go.
That's why I'm always saying, bro.
I love that it wasn't a prophecy, but because of, like, all the weight that they've put on everything he says, even when he's just trying to be supportive,
yeah,
his family is taking it as like, oh no, it's this horrible thing. He ruined my wedding. It's like, you did.
Yeah.
He straight up ruined it. And he doesn't, he's not saying that here. Obviously, he's just being supportive. He's like, yay, I'm back, and everybody.
But he's like, it was going to rain.
It was going to rain. Like,
it just was. I didn't. Yeah.
I didn't do anything.
Well, and I just realized there's a little bit of Frozen in there. Let it rain, let it snow, let it go. And then he like. But this all is very Lin-Manuel-ish.
Super
right Lin-Manuel. Here. I love it.
It's great.
Got a lot of apologies I got to say.
Hey, we're just happy that you're here, okay?
But come into the light.
The trip was over your night.
And no matter what happens, we're going to find our way.
Yo, I knew he never left. I heard him every day.
Why do you think she wouldn't say anything if she knew?
Seems like the world's biggest plot hole, right?
Yeah.
So, a couple of theories that I've got and then one that I've heard. Either she was just feeling haunted and maybe didn't really realize that
it was his actual voice.
It was his actual voice. She was just like hearing, this is what Bruno would say. Or she was hearing him, but she also knew that he wanted his secret protected because she heard him talking to himself about
She's
it.
She's like, I'll honor that.
And
sure.
So she was just like, yeah, I'll honor that. This is actually a fun theory that I heard from Sophie, our associate producer, that maybe the house was protecting him. And so the house was like deadening the sound anytime he was there so Delotix couldn't hear.
Yeah.
All of this is headcanon. We don't know. Kind of doesn't matter. Still a great movie.
But I love when he's apologizing and they say, we're just glad that you're here. And the thing about the identified patient, we saw in our last Encanto episode, mm-hmm. how Mirabel and Abuela, you know, mend the fences,
yeah.
so to speak. And Abuela takes accountability. And I love this whole scene. We're seeing that the entire family needs to make amends. The entire family has stuff they've got to own or they've got to make right or apologize for or forgive. Everyone's got a hand in this. And we don't talk about Bruno. The idea is that Bruno's the problem. He's the identified patient.
Right.
And he's really not. This is an entire system of people who interact, whose choices affect one another, whose prejudices and beliefs affect one another. And in order for the family to heal, the family has to heal. It's not, let's get Bruno some help.
Right.
And then we'll be okay.
Well, and it's a movie. We've only got 2 hours. So we kind of shorthand this. And it's a movie musical, so we do it all in... Not even a whole song. This is like one verse of a song.
Yeah.
In your opinion, are things all good and hunky-dory, or do we have a lot of work left to do once we get moved back into the casita?
I have seen rapid change happen all at once. Hmm. And when it happens, it's because people wanted to forgive anyway, but there were blocks here.
Yeah.
Right? They wanted to connect anyway, but there were blocks here and here.
Well, and I would assume that can often be helped by, like, major life circumstance changes like they've just had.
Yeah.
That'll lead to rapid change.
Yeah, absolutely. Big dramatic things happening kind of help people put their priorities
sure,
where they need to be.
Makes sense.
I don't think they have a lot of work from here. I do think the work now is avoidance of slipping into old patterns that have been there for so long that they just kind of will fall into them naturally. Mm-hmm. Like, something will happen and they'll go, Bruno!
No, man!
And then they'll go, wait.
Wait, no. We do talk about Bruno.
Yeah, we do talk about Bruno, and that one's actually on me, right?
Yeah.
It's not about the work they have ahead of them. It's about maintaining where they're at right now.
Right. Right.
And then just and moving forward from there. Bruno's magic is green. Caramel apple has got green in it. This is our flavor of the week. Visit the link for details. Eat with us.
Tastes like magic.
It does taste like magic.
It's really good.
Ah, oh, Bruno. What a great character.
Bruno, we love talking about you, man. Come back anytime.
So until next time.
Are you telling this story or am I?
I'm sorry, mi vida, go on.
And watch
mira
movies.
Mira películas.
Mira películas.